The targeting of women by the drug industry that we just discussed wasn't limited to medical devices. In fact, one of the biggest cash sources for the industry is birth control. And they figured out that if they deceived consumers about their products, they'd be more likely to switch to new, more expensive means of birth control. Joining me now to talk about the dangers of some very popular means of birth control is Seth Katz. Seth, it sounds like it's another drug company looking at another product that kills another woman in the United States. What is going on? What is this with marketing drugs that seem to target women? This Yaz case is a case, stories just won't go away.
You know, Mike, this was a drug that really wasn't needed in the marketplace. It was a birth control pill, or it is a birth control pill, amongst many birth control pills that are safe and effective for women that have been around for years. This was an example of a drug company seeing that there was another drug company with an antidepressant making some money and saying, hey, we can fill that niche through a birth control pill and expand the number of women using the birth control pill.
Hey Seth, when they came out with this, how many birth control options were out there that women could have used that did not kill them?
Scores of them, Pap, that had been around with proven forms of estrogen and progestin that had been safe and effective. But the problem with those, Mike, is they were available in generic. So the big brand companies weren't making any money on them.
Okay, so how did this Yaz product, this was Bayer Corporation, is that correct?
This is Bayer.
How did they go about taking this product and basically expanding the market to people who really, A, didn't need it, and B, were being lied to as far as what the product would actually do from an efficacy standpoint?
What they did was they combined a birth control pill with the approval for something called PMDD. 80% of the people that were polled on what that term meant and what that disease was, which stands for premenstrual dysphoric disorder, didn't know what it was. Now, 80% of women who menstruate know what PMS is. And what Bayer did was they marketed this product to treat PMS instead of the approved indication of PMDD.
Let me be clear. The FDA had not given them any clearance at all to market this drug for women who were suffering from PMS, which is 80% of the public, but 80% of women. But they did give them permission to market it for people with PMDD, which is 3%. So Bayer calculated they couldn't make enough money on the 3%, so they did what they call off-label and expanded the right to be able to use it for everybody, made it almost ubiquitous, told all these women it was going to cure their PMS, which was a lie. Did I get that right?
That is correct. They did the math that you just did and realized that 80% was a much bigger swimming pool than 3% of the women who actually suffer from PMDD. And what they did was they spent hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars promoting this product in an off-label manner. So much so that the FDA came down on them after several years and finally said, you need to run a $20 million corrective ad campaign. And when Bayer finally did that, they thought it was funny and created a hoax video to show how sincere they were in trying to deceive the public.
The idea was to take the spoof video where they basically were making fun of women. At the time they made the spoof video, hundreds of women had died from stroke, embolisms, heart attacks, all different kinds of problems. Hundreds of women had died, but they never really took that seriously, did they? To this day, they still don't take that seriously, do they?
They never took it seriously, Mike. Thousands of women had suffered from these blood clots, whether it was a pulmonary embolism, which is a blood clot in your lung, or a deep vein thrombosis, which has long-term, long-lasting effects of your circulatory system, or women who've had blood clots in their brain and strokes. I mean, these products, Yaz and Yasmin, and their generic version, which was also manufactured by Bayer, known as Ocella and Giandvi, have injured thousands of American women who should have never been on this product.
And the product is still on the market. The FDA had another chance to do the right thing. This is under the Obama administration. This isn't the Bush FDA. This is the Obama FDA. The Obama FDA had the right to do the right thing, which was to pull the product off the market. And instead, what did they allow the company to do?
In December of 2011, the FDA convened an advisory committee. And what that is a group of what are supposed to be independent doctors to come in and evaluate the product for the FDA and give the FDA a recommendation. Well, in this case, the advisory committee consisted of at least 4 to 6 people that we know of who had financial ties to Bayer. And in a very narrow vote of 15 to 11, the advisory committee recommended to keep the product on the market. But in a 21-4 vote, they voted to change the label. Now, that label change did occur in April of 2012, but by then it was too little, too late, and really the label change was weak at best.
So this is another situation. Industry makes a new product. They lie to the American public about the safety of the product. The FDA says, yeah, it's okay to lie, and it's business as usual as Bayer continues to sell this product, change the label slightly, but nothing's really different. Seth Katz, as usual, thank you for following this story. It is a story that affects all American women. I would talk to your doctor about, yes, get the truth.